you're meeting here to discuss the future of the NUM, when a lot of people feel that you ought to be meeting to wind up the organisation, because the signs increasingly point to the fact that there aren't actually very many moderates in Ulster.
Nonsense. We're not meeting here to discuss what we're going to do in the new Ulster movement. This meeting here today is a meeting of election agents from all over Northern Ireland, from 45 constituencies in Northern Ireland.
Are you now moving into the phase where you will, if necessary, be putting your own candidates into the field, where you are, in fact, in the process of becoming a political party?
I am convinced that what we have seen during this last week has been the beginning of the breakdown of the coalition which has formed the Unionist Party for something like 70 years. The coalition of moderate people, the coalition of extremists. It is breaking down. The extremists are going one way, the moderates are going the other way. I am convinced that an alliance of Catholic and Protestant, of socialist, of conservative, of liberal, will have to be forged in this community. And I am convinced that such a coalition can be forged. NUM would not itself suddenly turn itself into a political party as of itself. It can act as a catalyst for the forging of this alliance.
The point here is that we have a dedicated body of people here, Catholic and Protestant, as I've said earlier, and we're completely united for moderation. We're so united and so firm in our resolve that we fear nothing, and that includes the worst that the extremists, Paisleyite or otherwise, can do.
That we must be able to take it. We knew when we went into the new Ulster movement that the road ahead was not going to be easy. We knew we were subject, liable to be intimidated. We were liable to be threatened. We were liable to lose our jobs. But we also knew that the cause for which we were fighting demanded every sacrifice. And there is not a person in this room, there is not a person in the new Ulster movement throughout the province who is not prepared to accept whatever the risks are.
Mr. Hart, we are militant moderates.
Let us get this home to you, Mr. Hart. We are the majority. The decent, reasonable, and moderate people are the majority. The extremists are only a minority. We can take care of them.
One of the new parties to fight this election is the Alliance Party. At their Belfast headquarters, close tabs are kept on the party's progress in its battle to win general support. Oliver Napier is an energetic Alliance candidate.
The next item on the order paper is the joint election of the First Minister Designate and the Deputy First Minister Designate. Are there any joint proposals?
The alliance?
Yeah, well, I think the agreement has institutionalised a process where it's the stronger
voice within each of the blocks that stands to benefit. It's institutionalised that inter-ethnic competition to the detriment of the political centre. And there's a very serious question as to whether the political process can work without a strong centre.
But you're still under a lot of pressure in other seats.
Well, as I understand
it... Not least
it,
your own.
Naomi... Well, Naomi Long has been elected, Eileen Bell is... Seamus Close has been elected, Eileen Bell and Sean Leeson are definitely certain. Kieran McCarthy and I are both still in fighting.
All right, and you're going to be fighting to the bitter end there with Martin Meehan, who's beside you. How's it looking at the moment? You said last night that you felt you were marginally ahead?
No, the result is that on the figures on the board at the moment, Mr. Meehan is ahead. He's 360 ahead of me at the moment, but there are a number of unionist transfers to come through.
I am extremely confident and supremely confident that we're going to take this seat in Southampton. And saying that there, for the nationalist people here, this is a major historical breakthrough.
Sorry, Mr. Meehan, if you don't win this seat, David Ford, what are the implications for the Alliance Party caucus in the Assembly? Eileen Bell to be acting leader? Will you resign?
There were 124 rejected ballot papers, and I declare that Naomi Long has been elected to serve in Parliament for the East Belfast constituency.
I think most people in the society are sick, sore and tired of the demagoguery that comes from UKIP, but scapegoating the other, the problems that lie within our society.
There were some pretty unpleasant scenes in Carrickfergus tonight. A building was attempted to be burned out by those loyalist protesters. As you can see, that is a party office of the Alliance Party.
I'm delighted that the last 5 long years are over.
What's next for Naomi Long?
Sleep. Sleep, a lot of sleep.
But will we see you at the Assembly?
We'll get a lot of sleep and we'll see what happens.
For the Alliance Party. In Lisburn and Castlereagh, the party topped the poll in the first 4 counts, with the DUP losing the high-profile councillor Janet Gray in this first standalone council election in 22 years.
We're not just seeing better vote management, we're seeing more votes for Alliance. We're seeing a higher percentage of people coming out and actually backing Alliance in this poll. Thank you to my team and the people around me, because this was a team effort. But more than anything, I want to say thank you to the people who gave me their first preference votes today.
Gora, my uncle, Las Can Corla. Thank you, Mr. Deputy Speaker. I wanted my first formal comments in this chamber to be in Irish, to reflect the shared heritage of the language across all of the traditions in Northern Ireland.
Justice. All those in favour?
Aye.
Contrary? As there are ayes from all sides of the Assembly and there are no dissenting voices, I am satisfied the parallel consent has been demonstrated.
Finally,
Whilst we will no longer be colleagues in these institutions, I remain your steadfast colleague outside of them, as together we continue to champion the values of cooperation, interdependence and mutual respect which the European Union represents. Until one day we rejoin you here. Au revoir, auf Wiedersehen, Slán go fóill, goodbye for now.